Hi everyone, this is Melissa with Time Clock Support, and today we're going to go over your dashboard. So this is your dashboard. You have a nice little blue widget here that gives you your company name. This little pencil here is you can put a little welcome message or reminder for all of your employees to see. You can make the text red, you can make the text bold, whatever you feel like doing. Then you have your pending requests. This is just kind of like a central station for managers to know what needs to be done. For example, we have one pending request, timesheet request, that needs to be approved by management so that it can actually apply. So this is when employees want to change a time or request a time that maybe they forgot to clock in. And in order for it to apply, you need to approve it as a manager. So I just approved it by checking the little green check mark, or you could decline it by clicking the red X. So I'm gonna go back to my dashboard, and now I have zero pending requests. You have four possible clock-in errors. This is just to let you know, like this person, they work 75 hours, 145 hours, 25 hours. The system will automatically let you know anything over 13 hours in one 24-hour period. This will let you know if there's any absence requests. So if your employee is requesting vacation time or any type of time off, you can approve it or decline it. I approve that one. So there, that one's finished. And usually managers will go through this list once a day or once a week to make sure everything's up to par. This timesheets to verify, this is just gives you an overview of everyone's timesheet. You can see it in one place. If you require a clock-in image, you could see it here. And you can verify all of them at the same time, just letting the system know that these clock-ins are okay. When it's time to generate payroll, we're good to go. And those are done. All right, so then we go over to the who's in stats. This basically will let you know on your scheduler how many employees were scheduled for today, how many are clocked in now, and how many clocked in as a total for today. So you know that if you have five scheduled employees, only one is clocked in now, and only two have clocked in for the day, you are missing three employees. And you could click on any of these and just kind of see what's going on, like the who's in. You could see a list of who's in. Nobody's in right now for me, but you can click on that and it'll just give you some information. The My Task widget is basically that. It'll let you know what tasks are assigned to you and that need to be completed. Also, what tasks you assign to other people that have not been completed. The live stream is just an overview of what's going on the back end of your time clock. So it'll let you know when something's been approved or declined, when somebody's clocked in, when somebody's clocked out, when somebody went on break, all different types of things. Whenever somebody creates a task or finishes a task, you can kind of just go through the live stream and check it out. You have two graphs down here, and one is basically letting you know for that particular day, the 15th, what you can expect in payroll for that day based on the hours worked and the pay wage you entered in the employee's profile. You can change the graphs to another type of graph, whatever you're comfortable with. And then you have your time card. My time card is when you clock in and out. It just lets you know that information here. It lets you know this was a clock in and out type clock in. If it's a break, it'll let you know that it was a break. It lets you know the IP address for the clock in and the clock out. You can get your totals down here, how many clock in hours you worked, how many breaks you worked, and absence for that pay period. Whenever you generate a payroll, it automatically clears this out to start a new fresh time card. Up here, you have your quick add for your employees. You have your messages, so you can always click here when it's when the bell is ringing like it is here and it says two, that lets you know you have two messages. You can always send a message by clicking here. This is just basically another overview of your pending request widget. It's just a little reminder. And this is your tasks as well. This little question mark is so that you can have a quick tutorial of the icons and the widgets if you ever need a little reminder of any kind. You can access that on any page. Here's your clock in button. Once you click clock in, it will change to start break and clock out. So you're either able to start your break now or clock out, depending on, you know, what you do in your business. So that's your dashboard. Of course, if you have any questions, you can always click the live chat down at the bottom. And feel free to ask us any questions. We hope you guys are enjoying the time clock. And thanks so much. Have a wonderful day.